In the Age of Ancients, the world was unformed, shrouded by fog. A land of grey crags, arch trees, and everlasting dragons. But then there was fire. And with fire came disparity. Heat and cold, life and death, and of course, light and dark. Then from the dark they came and found the souls of lords within the flame. The first of the dead. The wish of Izalith and her daughters of chaos. Glim, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights. And the furtive pygmy, so easily forgotten. With the strength of lords, they challenged the dragons. Gwyn's mighty bolts peeled apart their stone scales. The witches wooed great firestorms. Ito unleashed a miasma of death. The scales betrayed his own, and the dragons were no more. Thus began the Age of Fire. But soon flames will fade, and only dark will remain. Even now, there are only embers, and man sees not late, but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side.
Dark Souls Remastered is a 2018 game that was developed by From Software. It is a re-release of 2011's Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition, which was a spiritual successor to Demon's Souls on PlayStation 3 back in 2009. The 2018 release was made for all those who missed out on the original game on Xbox 360 and PS3. The remastered version is just as difficult, offering a challenging combat system, daunting bosses, areas with deadly traps, and cryptic lore with explanation. The players are expected to overcome all of these challenges.
Unlike other games that allow you to control difficulty level, Dark Souls offers the same difficulty and challenges to everyone who plays the game, especially for the first timers. With the game being known for its difficulty, you'd think many would give up early on. But Dark Souls does something special to keep the players engaged. It makes them think carefully about how they approach each challenge in the new way, whether it's by dodging enemy attacks, buffing their weapons with powerful spells, or better management of their stamina or health. The game always allows the players to rethink their gameplay styles and try over and over again. Why do we keep trying over and over again? Isn't that the definition of insanity? A recent study shows that failure is the main way to lead to success. If players are unable to experience these setbacks and challenges, then they are unlikely to enjoy playing the game at all. Failure creates a determination for players to succeed, with each challenge, players are able to try again and again, changing their approach and developing their strategies until they can get it right and win.
Game designers want players to experience constant failure so that the occasional successes feel more like a victory, drawing out deeper emotional reactions to each attempt and accomplishment. Without these challenges, players would not be able to implement the developed skills and strategies, and the game can quickly become way too easy or boring. Much like day-to-day life, games let you practice what you learn. Not only can you use these lessons in the game you are playing, but also take advantage of them in real-life scenarios and other games you may play in the future. The tagline for Dark Souls is "Prepare to Die," drawing in the interests of players to keep going on until they can't be defeated. The frustrations a game creates leaves players wanting more and allows them to create a community of players to share the experiences and learn together with. Thomas Edison also once said, "I didn't fail 1,000 times. The light bulb was an invention with 1,000 steps." Dark Souls is the same case. It is designed to make you want to try over and over again, because we know there is something in the end that is worth dying for. What that reward is can be determined by the player. Perhaps it's the sense of pride and accomplishment of beating a hard boss, or maybe something as simple as getting to progress to the next chapter of the game.
No! What the fuck?! No! Yes! Fucking finally! Holy shit! Speaking of which, Dark Souls also does an incredible job of giving the player the sense of loss and wonder, seamlessly connecting the areas like a giant spiderweb. It encourages the players to explore every part of the game, which leads back to why the game makes them want to keep trying to get through the amazing looking but difficult areas of a game. There is no in-game map in Dark Souls, and gives you a single and only clue to go on in the early game. There is no drawn-out path to take in the game. You could be walking atop the high walls of a city, traveling down to the streets filled with insane denizens, and the next, you could be running in a poison-filled swamp. You can take an elevator from the swamp, leading you to a valley filled with drakes, and then to a dark forest that brings you back to the walls where you started. And this is only just a portion of a game. Dark Souls may start you at the central hub-esque area, but you quickly discover how just deep the networking of these areas lead. You have to figure out how to get to those two bells, and discover on your own what happens when you have wrong both of them. To find these bells, you need to explore quite the number of areas in the game, and because how seamlessly they are connected without obvious visual cues, you will definitely get lost.
Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are actually two bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below, in the ruins at the base of Blight Town. Ring them both, and something happened. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on. But I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land of the undead?
Now go to the church and go ring the first bell of the awakening.
Why, what a surprise. I didn't expect you to make it. Oh, somebody rang the bell. Wait, was it you? You never give up, do you? I don't know how you do it. Well, don't stop now. Only one more. But it's going to be suicide.
And after ringing the second bell of the awakening, he says this.
Did you ring the second bell? That is incredible, I must say. But now, we have a new problem. It's noisy, it snores, and its breath is lethal. This is no laughing matter, I tell you. Damn, that stench. And I was really beginning to like it here. Maybe it's time I do something about it.
Is Dark Souls perfect? Absolutely not. Are there other games that also do this, or even better? Yes, there are, but Dark Souls can be seen as an inspiration to all games that engage players in a difficult gameplay and lore. Games such as Neo, Sultan Sanctuary, and Cobain are all inspired by brutal gameplay of Dark Souls, yet it adds their own flavors to make them separate from Dark Souls. Games such as Celeste alter their own gameplay difficulty that is completely different from Dark Souls, yet it still teaches the importance of repeated failures and eventual success. After either they're continuing the Age of Fire or ushering the Age of Dark, the credits begin to roll, and the player reflects on all the hours and the efforts they put into getting to this moment. Even with countless hardships, continuous screaming, and endless ragings, players are still left with satisfied and accomplished that they have finally beaten the Dark Souls. Now go do the New Game Plus.